We'll discuss systems of equations and inequalities in this lecture. A system of linear equations in two variables is a set of two or more linear equations. We saw in the last few lectures how linear equations represent lines. So we're going to be working with two or more lines. A solution to the system of equations is a point in plane that satisfies all the equations in the system. So if you're working with two lines, and we want to look for a solution to that system of equations that consists these two lines, then that means a point that belongs to both lines. So if you have two lines that intersect, then this point of intersection is called a unique solution to the system of equations. A system of equations that has just a unique solution is called a consistent independent system. You can also have two lines that overlap each other, occupy the same space in plane, which means every single point on this line is going to be a solution, and such a system is called consistent dependent system. Since there are infinitely many points on this line, we have infinitely many solutions. Notice any point that is not on the line will not be a solution. You can also have two parallel lines, and that would mean that two lines do not intersect, or that there is no solution. Such a system is called inconsistent system. Let's take concrete examples so you can actually see. So the first method by which we solve system of equations is the graphing method. Graphing method means exactly that. Just graph the two lines and read off the solution from your graph paper here. So let's say we are working with this system. We have to graph these two lines, so that's good practice for you to review graphing lines. Remember, two points determine a line. So if you take each of the equations and make your table of points, and then you can graph it. So let's make an xy chart. Let's put 0 in for x here. So 3 times 0 is 0. Negative 2y equals 4. If you solve that for y, you'll get y equals negative 2. So 0, negative 2 is the point on this line right here, the first line. Let's take x equals 2. 3 times 2 is 6. 6 minus 2y equals 4. Go ahead, solve that for y and verify that that gives you y equals 1. So 0, negative 2, and 2, 1 are points on this first line. So let's plot them. So here's 0, negative 2, and here's 2, 1. And that will be this first line here. All right, go ahead and plot x plus y equals 3 on your own. Make a chart and plot the line. We'll give you a few moments. All right, assuming you have come back from pausing, here is 0, 3. So when x is 0, y is 3. When y is 0, x is 3. So those are your x and y intercepts for that line. So plot them. So we have 3, 0, 3, and 3, 0. Plot the line, and now remember what we said. We were looking for a point in the plane that satisfies both equations, and you can see how this point 2, 1 satisfies both equations. 2 plus 1 is 3. 2 times 2 is 6. 6 minus 2 is 4, because 2 times 1 is 2. So this point 2, 1 belongs to this line as well as that line, and so that is your solution. So anytime you're looking for solution to the system of equations, you just graph them, read off the point. All right, so now let's take a look at system of inequalities. What changes would you have to make? As you saw before, when we were looking at a single inequality, 3x minus 2y less than 4, you know how to graph that. So let's do that. So again, we have to plot the two points. Right, like just like before, and the two lines, they're going to be dotted lines. Why? Because you have strictly less than and strictly greater than. So the lines are not part of your solution. Now what? You saw before that you did test value for each line, so we're going to do that. So let's start with 3x minus 2y less than 4. Plot 0, 0. 0, 0 is a point right here. It's not on either of the lines. And so when you plug it in, 0 smaller than 4, which is a true statement. So for that line, you're going to shade that because 0, 0 is part of the solution. But here, 0 plus 0 is bigger than 3. 0 is bigger than 3 is a false statement. So that 0, 0 is not part of that inequality. So you're going to shade this region here. And so the solution to the system of inequalities is where the shading is common. So you can see how this part right here, where the shading overlaps, is your solution. Okay, let's see that again. So 0, 0 is part of the solution for this inequality, so you'll shade that. 0, 0 is not part of the solution for this inequality, so you'll shade that part. And you can see this is where they overlap, and that is your solution set. So all the points here in this region are your solutions. So for example, 0, 5 is a solution to this system of inequality. There are infinitely many points in this region that will satisfy the system of inequalities. All right, the other method is substitution method to solve system of equations. And we're looking for other methods because, as you can see, if you were to graph equations of lines, you can't always read off the point. It depends on where the point of intersection happens to be. So if you don't have a finer scale, you might not be able to read off the point exactly. So to find exact solutions, we have to find some other methods. All right, so let's start a substitution method. So let's take a look at the system of equations here. And to do substitution, the first step is to solve one of the equations for one of the variables. So let's say we start with x plus y equals 3. That's an equation that we're starting with because it's easier to solve for y. So we have to undo the plus x, so subtract x from both sides, and we get y equals negative x plus 3. Since the y coordinate is given by this for the second line, and we're looking for a solution that satisfies both equations, which means that this y coordinate should also satisfy this first equation. So we're going to, in the second step, substitute this value of the variable in here. So the equation will look like how then? It will be 3x minus 2 times, and then this y value is going to be the negative x plus 3. So we're going to replace this y with negative x plus 3 that we got in the first step. And now you have an equation in one variable which you can solve, multiply across, and then solve. So you have 5x equals 10 or x equals 2. Once you find the x value, then step 3 would be to substitute the x value back here to get the y coordinate. So we'll have negative 2 plus 3 or 1. You can always go back and check and make sure that it works on both equations. And so our solution is 2, 1, like you saw in the graph before. So this is another way of solving a system of equations. All right, try this on your own. Pause the video here, please. All right, assuming you've come back, step one, so we'll use the first equation in this case, solve the equation for y. So just add y and subtract 4, and then use that value of y in the second equation and substitute here. So 6x minus 2 times y, solve the equation for x now, because you have an equation in x. And now look what happened. Oh, 8 equals 3. Is that a true statement? No, 8 cannot equal 3. So what does that mean? That means this equation has no solution because it's a false statement. And so what that means is that this system of equations has no solutions, or that it is an inconsistent system. If you were to actually solve the equations, you'll see that they are two parallel lines because the slope is the same. Both equations have slope 3, so they're parallel lines. Okay, the third method is using elimination method when it's not that easy to substitute. So let's say something like this. We can still do substitution method, it just will be a little more tedious. So here's what we do. We line up the equation so that the x's and the y's are lined up under each other. And then the second step is to multiply one or both equations by a constant so that when you add these two equations, you get a third equation in which one of the variables has added up and gone to zero. But what does that mean? It's very difficult to understand my words right now, but if you see it, you'll understand. So I'm going to multiply this first equation by a 3 and the bottom equation by a 2. If you do that, look what happens. This first equation becomes 9x minus 6y equals 18. This becomes 10x plus 6y equals 4. Both these equations are equivalent to these equations, so the solutions are going to be not changing. But the advantage of this new system of equations is that if you add these two equations, we get a third equation where the negative 6y and positive 6y, which added up to 0y and gave us equation in one variable, which allows us to solve. So you can see x would equal 22 over 19, right? Because you solve that for x, which means that now we can plug that value of x either in first equation or the second equation and get y. So we do that, let's say put it in the second equation, and 5 times 22 19ths plus 3y equals 2, multiply 5 times 22, and now solve for y, so 2 minus 110 over 19, keep going and you get negative 72 over 19, divide both sides by 3, which will give you negative 24 over 19. So your solution here is going to be 22 over 19 for x, negative 24 19ths for y. You can also do substitution and verify for yourself it will be the same solution. It will just be a little more tedious. This makes it a little bit easier to solve. So it depends on the context and what equations you have to decide what method you're going to use to solve the system of equations. So again, line up the x's and the y's, multiply one or both equations by a constant so that the new equations, when you add them, one of the variables is eliminated. And that's why the name, elimination method, you're eliminating one of the variables so that we can solve for the other variable, find the x value, then find the y value, and that gives you your solution. You can always go back and check. It's easy to make sure you got the right answer here by going back and checking that they satisfy, the point you got satisfies both equations. All right, try this problem on your own. Let's do the first step together. We lined up the two equations. Now go ahead and solve. Assuming you've come back, so what should we multiply by? Let's multiply the top row by negative 2. Okay, so let's see what happens then. We got negative 2 times 3x, which is negative 6x, negative 2 times 2y, which is negative 4y, negative 2 times 6, which is negative 12. All right, add the two equations and let's see what we got. We got 0 equals 0. All the variables got eliminated, and you have a true statement. When this is happening, you say this is an identity, which means this is true for all x and y. So that would mean that we have infinitely many solutions. What are the solutions? Basically, these two lines occupy the same space. And so that would mean that all points that are on this line are solutions to this system. That's why there are infinitely many solutions in such a system. We know we called it consistent dependent. All right, try these on your own.